Hello， 大家，我是 Cindy。Hello, everyone. I'm Cindy。又到了晨读英文的时间。那这个新闻呢，其实是上周的新闻，但是不好意思，因为上周真的太忙了，没有时间把影片做好，所以今天呢，再来跟大家一起看上周的新闻。因为我还是很想要带大家来看看这两篇新闻。那在影片开始之前呢，要再宣传一下，我现在在参选新竹市议员，恳请大家到我的脸书宋品莹新竹市东区议员参选人看看我的政见。最近呢，也有志工朋友帮我拍了我的纪录片，也请大家帮我按赞追踪，加油打气，谢谢大家，拜托支持。好，那我们现在就回到今天的文章。今天有两篇文章都来自路透社。第一篇是 Complaints about Russia's chaotic mobilization grow， 对于俄罗斯混乱动员的抱怨越来越多。 Complaints 抱怨 about Russia's chaotic mobilization， chaotic 就是非常混乱的， mobilize mobilization 是动员， mobilization grow 这个 complaints 一直在增加。The strongly pro-Kremlin editor of Russia's state-run RT News Channel expressed anger on Saturday that enlistment officers were sending call-up papers to the wrong men, as frustration about a military mobilization grew. 我们来看连谁都在抱怨了呢？ A strongly pro-Kremlin editor of Russia's state-run RT News Channel，所以是俄国的 Russia state run 俄国国营的 news channel， 他们国营的新闻频道。那这个人呢，他是 strongly pro Kremlin editor， 他是极度 pro 就是支持谁的，所以他是极度支持克林姆林宫的编辑。他表达了愤怒， expressed anger on Saturday。 什么事情让他愤怒呢？ That enlistment officers were sending call-up papers to the wrong men。 他说呢，征兵人员 enlistment officers 征兵的官员 were sending call-up papers， 他们正在寄送征召的文件 to the wrong men， 是寄给错误的人。As frustration about a military mobilization grew， 那他在抱怨这件事情的同时呢，民间对于军事动员的不满情绪与日俱增。Wednesday's announcement of Russia's first public mobilization since World War II to shore up its faltering Ukraine war has triggered a rush for the border, the arrests of over 1,000 protesters, and unease in the wider population.Wednesday's announcement， 星期三公布一件事情， of Russia's first public mobilization since World War II， 是俄罗斯自从第二次世界大战以来首次的公开动员。To shore up its faltering Ukraine war， 那他们这个动员的目的是要来 shore up 是要去支持支援，要去支援他们 faltering Ukraine war。 Faltering 是步履蹒跚的，所以他们要去支援他们目前没有什么进展的乌克兰战争。那这件事情呢，这两个逗号等于一个括号，所以我们可以从这边跳到这边。 Since World War IIHas triggered， 所以这件事情呢 ，has triggered 引发了 a rush for the border， 大家呢逃往哪里 ？rush 就是要冲到哪里，所以很多人呢就冲到了 border 边境。还有什么事情 ？The arrests of over 1,000 protesters， 还有超过1,000多名的抗议者被逮捕。And unease in the wider population， 还有广大民众的不安。那这边我们看到它的用法 has triggered 第一件事情，第二件事情，还有 and 然后加第三件事情。那这边我们看到俄罗斯的动员不仅引发了广大人民的不满，连支持政府的国营媒体也开始抗议了。好，那现在我们来看下一篇新闻。这一篇是我今天主要想要带大家来看非常令人伤心的一篇新闻。 Russia's mobilization hits hard in poor rural Buryatia。 俄罗斯的动员，刚我们看到的 mobilization 动员这件事情 hits hard in poor rural Buryatia， 在贫穷而且偏远的农村地区，这个地方 Buryatia 布里亚特农村造成了沉重的打击。A day after Russian President Vladimir Putin ordered a partial mobilization to boost the armies fighting in Ukraine, officials arrived at Alexander Bezdorozhny's house with draft papers ordering him to present himself for service. But they were calling on a dead man. A day after Russian President Vladimir Putin ordered a partial mobilization to boost the armies fighting in Ukraine. 在俄罗斯普丁总统下令 partial mobilization 部分的动员用来 boost the armies 支援军队 fighting in Ukraine 支援在乌克兰作战的军队的第二天呢 a day after, officials arrived at Alexander Bezdorozhny's house.官员就来到这个人他的家了 with draft papers 带着兵单 draft papers 就是兵单 ordering him to present himself for service 命令他 present himself 就是献身献身做什么呢 for service 要来服务其实就是要服役 but they were calling on a dead man 但是呢他们在征召的其实是一个死人 call on someone call on 就是号召征召的意思 Bezdorozhny who suffered from chronic inflammation of the lungs died aged 40 in December 2020 at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic while on a ventilator at a hospital in his Siberian hometown of Ulan-Ude just north of Mongolia his sister Natalia SemyonovaTold Reuters, 这个先生呢 who suffered from chronic inflammation of the lungs, 他长期以来有肺部的发炎 chronic 就是长期的 inflammation 是发炎 lungs 是肺部 died age 40 in December 2020, 他在2020年的12月40岁的时候就过世了所以是两年前就过世了 at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, 是在疫情大流行最严重的时候 while on a ventilator at a hospital in his Siberian hometown of Ulan-Ude 那他过世的时候呢他是有使用呼吸器的 ventilator 然后在医院那位于他西伯利亚的家乡在 Ulan-Ude 这个地方 just north of Mongolia 是在蒙古的北部那这是他的妹妹或是姐姐告诉路透社的It hurts me that the state only remembered him after he was dead. Semyonova, a professional musician and activist in Ulan-Ude, told Reuters, recounting the call-up for her brother. He was an invalid and had never served in the army. 她的姐妹就说呢, It hurts me that the state only remembered him after he was dead. 他说国家只有在他死后才记得他这件事情让我很伤心那他的姐妹呢是 a professional musician 专业的音乐家 an activist 也是一位运动人士他在 recounting 就是回忆征召这件事情的时候这么说 he was an invalid 他说呢他是免疫的 invalid 如果你形容东西是 invalid 的话表示它是坏掉的也就是说这个人他身体是有问题的所以他是免疫的体质 and had never served in the army 而且呢从未在军中服役 in Buryatia a mostly rural region wrapped around the southern shore of Lake Baikal The mobilization has seen some men drafted regardless of their age, military record, or medical history, according to interviews with local residents, rights activists, and even statements by local officials. 在这个 Buryatia, a mostly rural region, 一个大部分是很乡下的地区 wrapped around the southern shore of Lake Baikal, 它是环绕贝加尔湖的南岸的这个地区The mobilization has seen some men drafted regardless of their age. 我们可以看到他动员的一些男人 regardless of their age, 不管他们的年纪 military record 他们的军事记录如何 or medical history 或是他们的病史如何都不管 according to interviews with local residents 根据呢跟当地居民的访问还有呢 rights activists 还有人权人士的采访 and even statements by local officials 甚至是当地官员都这么说Brilliant rights activists suspect that the burden of the mobilization and the war itself is falling on poor ethnic minority regions to avoid triggering popular anger in the capital Moscow, which is 6,000 kilometers away. Brilliant rights activists, 当地的维权人士 suspect that, 他们怀疑呢, the burden of the mobilization,动员的这个负担 and the war itself 还有战争本身 is falling on poor ethnic minority regions 这一些压力这些负担落在贫穷的少数民族地区 ethnic 是民族 minority ethnic minority 是少数民族 regions 地区 to avoid triggering popular anger 为了要避免引起 popular anger 是广泛民众的愤怒 in the capital Moscow 在首都莫斯科 which is 6,000 kilometers away 那莫斯科呢位在这个地方的6000公里外看到这一篇让我觉得非常的难过因为第一篇我们可以看到动员引起了人民的愤怒而为了不要引起太多的民怨他们就先从贫困的少数民族地区下手那今天的新闻英文就到这边再一次恳请大家到我的脸书宋品莹新竹市东区议员参选人看看我的政见帮我按赞追踪加油打气距离选举只剩2个月了我非常需要你的支持每个星期天早上我会分享跟英文学习相关的内容如果喜欢今天的影片别忘了帮我订阅按赞还有分享给你所有在学英文的朋友哦 I'll see you next time 拜拜